Hey there, it's Red, and today I am with my best friend Sierra, who is visiting me on my birthday, even though I am really contagious. I'm sorry.
I'm not breathing.
Like, seriously, she brought me presents, and it's beautiful, and I was crying, and she made me feel better. Anyway, so today we are going to be doing the best friend booktube tag, which is basically the best friend tag you see going around YouTube's, like in different areas of YouTube, except I've kind of customized it a little bit to fit booktube. So yeah.
Question number one.
How and when did you meet?
I don't think we ever officially met.
Yeah, we kind of just knew about each other, and I didn't like her because...
And I didn't like her.
Yeah, because we just heard really bad things about the other.
From people who we no longer like. So yeah. That kind of tells you.
And then she had dated this guy, because we met in high school. You met, your freshman year?
We're going to talk about this story, yeah.
Yes, we're going to talk about this story.
We did meet in high school, and things are rather dramatic in high school.
and she dated this guy before, you know, she learned. Accidentally dated this guy, kind of, because we talked
on this guy, off on her.
And because she was just trying, after they broke up, he was just like so obsessed with her, he was just trying to get him to be obsessed with somebody else, which just happened to be me. And I remember I gave him my number and we talked for like one night, and the next morning he was calling me his girlfriend, and I'm like, when did this happen?
There was no discussion about this, which is kind of how it happened with us. It was just kind of like, I knew him for a day.
Yeah, so basically, and then we both got invited to a mutual friend's house for a summer party, basically, yeah.
And was it a birthday?
No, it was just at her house, because you were spending the night at her house, and I kind of just invited myself. invited myself, and she...
Sounds about right.
Our friend fell asleep early, and she and I kept talking. We talked about everything.
We stayed up, like, almost all night, just back and forth, just...
We didn't, like, grow into best friends. Like, we were seriously, like, instant best friends. We were attached to the hip. Nobody ever saw us without the other.
Long time we just lived at each other's houses.
Pretty much. Yeah. Like, it just... The rest is history.
Yep.
All right, more questions. We got more. Okay.
That was long.
All right, first book bonding.
We kind of discussed this earlier, and I don't want to say it.
Okay, I'm so sorry to say it. And it's not because of the book, it's because of what the movie's made it out to be.
Okay.
It's all right. I'd say that first.
I would say the first thing we bonded over was Twilight, because
we both read
Edward
Twilight
Cullen and Emmett Cullen and Jasper Hill at one point did rule our high school lives.
And that same mutual friend that... is basically responsible for us.
For our friendship.
She was really obsessed with Twilight. We're talking, showed up to school wearing crazy glitter to sparkle like vampires.
Trying not to go in the sunlight to be extremely pale.
We were never that bad. We just enjoyed the books and then going to the movies.
We read it, and then we went to the midnight movies like every other teenager, but we never took it that far.
Kind of showed us that we had reading in common more than anything, as opposed to just a love for Twilight. All right, number three. What is your favorite memory together?
Okay, me and you, with Laura, and we went around taking all those random photos all day long, and I had the crazy lime green jeans that you had just gotten.
And you guys stole my clothes so that I had to walk down the street looking like a hooker?
Yes, and we were wearing socks in the front yard, and it was, like, randomly raining, and we had that picture in the huge chair, and we literally just spent all day, I don't even know what we were actually doing, but we just traveled Sacramento taking random photos and videos and being stupid and playing, like, guitar. And...
Oh, that was a different day, I think. That was a different day, because...
Well, I saw your shoes because we have the picture and we're all in our socks and I have your shoes on my hands. So.
Oh, yeah, because that was just me, you, and Laura.
Okay, no, because I'm thinking of a different
day. That's when we
walked
to the mall in
the rain.
Yeah,
that's what I was thinking of. Yeah,
but that was a good day, too.
That's probably not my favorite memory of us, but it was fun.
That was a good day.
They talked me into trying on my friend's clothes that she was giving away, and while I did that, they stole my clothes, so that when we walked to the mall, I walked to the mall in the pouring rain looking like a hooker, and then...
And your other friend's clothes.
Yeah, and because they wouldn't give me my clothes back, and then a car drove by next to a puddle and completely drenched me in
water. And she was a red hooker.
But no, I think that was a really good day. I forgot about that day with Laura when we took all those pictures. Mm-hmm. A really good day.
I think... So sweet.
I think one of my best memories of us, though, that I always kind of think about, is when your dad had that electric wheelchair thing.
And we just, like, rode it all around your neighborhood, and then we got stuck in a ditch. That was a really good day.
Yeah, that was a good day.
And you have to understand that we're the type of friends where we can be out doing absolutely nothing and still be having the best time ever. Number four, your favorite book. My favorite book, as I've talked about a million times, is Silver Linings Playbook by Matthew Quick.
Because okay, I've not read that book, but I recently watched the movie for the first time and then wrote a psychology paper about it, and it was a pretty fantastic movie, so definitely worth picking up the book for, obviously. I don't know if I can answer this question because I can't even think right now. I can list off a lot of books that I really do like. I really like Shiver by Maggie...
Steve Otter?
Yeah, thank you. Have you read it?
I have not.
Oh, it's really
but
good.
I'm a booktuber. I know these
yeah,
books.
Yeah, okay, obviously. Okay. Well, that series is really good. I really, really loved it.
Well, you like, read the first Mortal Instruments.
I was about to say, the Mortal Instruments series. I don't know if that would be my favorite, but...
Harry Potter.
Okay, well, duh, Harry Potter.
You can pick Harry Potter. It's okay.
But I feel like that's almost the
same. I feel like I'm retired to... Guys, don't I talk about Harry Potter pretty much nonstop?
Deathly Hallows.
I know.
Which I bought you one, by the way.
Did you really?
No, I really did. I bought you and, like, Lauren and Kate.
Oh my god, you're too cute.
I seriously bought, like, not everybody, just,
you
like,
kind of our... You know my best friend is because... Did you guys see my Christmas ornament that she made me?
Oh my god. I actually did. I showed it to them
in
the vlog.
Oh my god, it's the cutest freaking thing. I should have watched it then.
And they were so worried. No, they were so worried that you were going to see the vlog before I gave it to you.
You're right. I didn't. I haven't seen it, but I should. But it was the cutest thing ever.
Favorite author, Matthew Quick.
Can we not talk about this right now? Because I need to, like, replay every book I've ever read, and I'm not prepared for this. Can I be cliche and say Nicholas Sparks because he should write My Imaginary Boyfriend? And it's funny because there's another question on here that we talked about earlier, which we didn't really talk about it because we knew that we were going to do this vlog and we're not allowed to do that, but she had previously mentioned it, and I'm going to pick somebody else for my book boyfriend. But... I want Nicholas Sparks to write my boyfriend. Okay.
Remember I was telling you guys about how the only Nicholas Sparks book I read was The Last Song, and it basically ripped my heart out and then drove over it with the school bus? Yeah, it was her fault. She was the one that kept talking about how I should read it. And it was really, really good, but it destroyed me.
Sorry, we're really tired. We're coming back to this video after dinner. Yeah, after dinner and pie, because I don't like cake. Well, I do like cake, but I don't really, I don't know. I prefer pie for my birthday. It's an influential book.
I'm going to relate with you here, because I know you've read this book. I read this book a long time ago, and then Caitlin, maybe not recently, but more recently read it, and it kind of, like, brought back a whole bunch of memories of it. But 13 Reasons Why, it's a pretty influential book. I don't know, that one, like, just really, like, struck, like, some heart. Like heartstrings.
I don't know. It's just really, it just gets you.
Yeah. Like,
and it's like you know that it's not going to have a happy ending because there's no way for it to have a happy ending, and you still kind of hope for it anyway, which is really sad.
But it just kind of makes you think about, like, what's going on in other people's lives when you don't even know, and, like, how you treat others and why. And, you know, the 13 Reasons Why doesn't have to be a negative 13 reasons. There can always be that one good. And
probably Silver Linings Playbook, just because that's, like, the biggest part of the reason it became my favorite book. And I feel like it kind of reminds you that even if things don't always turn out the way you expect them to, sometimes they're turning out just the way they should. An inside joke.
Series of 102, Your Zipper's in the Middle.
My Zipper's in the Middle.
Lamp. I love Lamp.
That's a good one.
Laughing so hard, or my...
That's what you said, Lamp, right?
No, that's laughing about my penis. Laughing so hard, my sombrero falls off and I drop my taco.
These are our own acronyms for laughing, because they're more suited for our lives.
Better than ha-ha and LOL.
Laughing at my penis! A hated book. For me, it was Breaking Dawn, because... And I know I talked about this in the live show, but... Sorry, it sounds like somebody's coming in. But I know I talked about this in the live show, that when you guys asked me, like, what I rated it and what I thought about it, and I basically told you if I could rate it less than one star, I would, and it shouldn't exist. Yeah, I really hate that book.
I forgot about that book and how bad that book was.
It was really bad.
And the sad part is, it was the best movie.
Where would you travel together?
Australia.
Obviously
Australia.
Yeah, Australia.
Right. Oh man, anywhere, it doesn't even matter where, you can just post some.
Yeah, we'll pretty
Australia
much go anywhere, but Australia is, like, kind preferable. Of our place. Yeah. Overrated book. Hunger Games.
Twilight.
Favorite gift from the other.
Well, dang, we've had a lot of gifting.
Yeah.
A lot of gifting. There's been a lot. Okay, probably these lime green skinny jeans, like, bright, like, fluorescent, neon, might as well be glowing if you hit me while I'm walking on the street, it's murder, not an accident. Bright green.
Alright, I can actually show you what my favorite gift is from her. I have, like, I feel like there's pretty much nothing she's given me that I haven't loved, but I think this is the only time I've ever thought that giving somebody pictures was a good idea for a gift, because I actually absolutely love it. Most of the time I think pictures are kind of a cop-out, but this gift I actually love. I love these. She gave me, like, and it's a really cool frame. Like, I feel like if you're gonna give somebody a gift, you have to deal with
spinny.
Yeah, like, seriously, it's got, like, it's like this spinny thing, and she filled the whole thing up with pictures of us. Of course, they're all really old pictures of us now, but
at the time they were new pictures.
Look at us. Look how fabulous we are. Like, it's fantastic. I know, it's really dusty. But this is my absolute favorite gift from her, because it just, like, it's one of those gifts that's, like, full of memories. I love looking at the pictures on this, and I keep it on my bookshelf, so that says something.
You know what? But my favorite gift that I've given her this far are these really cool crowns that she hasn't used yet. But look how cool these things are.
Yeah, that's pretty up there. She just gave me these for my birthday today. Yeah. She gave me some clothes and stuff, too, and they're really cute.
It's actually really funny, because she got me these earrings that literally, maybe, I don't know, a week ago, I was at Forever 21, and I almost bought these earrings, because I was head over heels in love with them, except I just bought, like, 6 pairs of jeans, so I decided not to spend the money on these earrings, and I opened up my gift from her, and there are these earrings.
Oh my god, does she know me, or does she know me?
Wavelength. Book boyfriend, don't fall in love with Augustus Waters, your heart will be broken.
Really?
I didn't say how it would be broken.
Okay, okay. Seriously, we just went over, we're redoing this right now, because of spoilers. So I think this is the best we're going to get. But for me, like, I was just saying how I normally picked Augustus Waters more because I didn't know who to pick for a while, except I just read the...
You don't get to know him long enough.
Really?
Really? I'm not saying anything. I'm just saying that you don't personally get to know him long enough in this book because it comes from the perspective of somebody else. That's all.
Okay. Okay, I'll accept it. But I recently read The Unbecoming Mara Dyer series, and which you really, really need to read, but I feel like every time I give you a book,
We're not talking about this.
Okay. Anyway, so I recently read it, and there's the main, like, kind of male protagonist, like, outside of Mara's not a male, but... So, like, her love interest, Noah Shaw, and he is perfect.
He is amazing. I don't think I've ever been in love with a book character more. Like, he should be real so we can get married, because he is that fantastic. And I had one of my coworkers read this book, because Lauren read this book. I gave it to her to read, and she was just like, oh my god. She was like, what is with Noah? Because he's perfect.
I really love every boy that Nicholas Sparks creates. He should really just design my husband. But other than that, Sam from Shiver just, I don't know, gives me shivers. Something about that boy.
Book pet peeves. Okay, I know I have them. Like, I hate being deceived by a really good cover and having it be a bad book.
That's exactly what I was just thinking. I was like, man, okay, well, we were just talking about books and covers. Okay, book pet peeve. When they make a series of books and they don't start off the first one with one on it, but all of the following in the series say 2, 3, 4, and it doesn't start the same, I can't.
That is so frustrating. I actually...
Wait, okay, I have this book, and I think it's called The Fire Will Fall or something. I don't know. I never read it, because I bought it because I thought it sounded really cool. And meanwhile, I'm, like, reading this book, I'm like, wow, why do all these characters know each other so well already? Like, this is really weird. Like, I feel like I'm missing something. And so I look it up, because there's no indication that it's a sequel. No indication whatsoever. I just thought it sounded like a cool book. Only to find out there's a whole other first book. So that book has been sitting on my shelf for years, because I've never picked up the first book, because I thought it was, like, a stamp.
That's a pet peeve.
Yes. That's so frustrating.
Oh. I let out a breath I didn't know I'd been holding in every book ever. Like, how do you not know you're holding your breath? Like, don't
you're
you start
always
to get dizzy?
Holding your breath.
Like, seriously. Favorite chapter books from your childhood. Favorite picture books.
Goosebumps. Yeah, Goosebumps, definitely.
There was this one, and it started out with these kids, like, they broke into, like, some old magic shop, and there was, like, this can, and it was, like, goo or whatever, and then, like, they weren't supposed to open the can or something, and they did, and the goo kept growing and growing and growing, and pretty soon it was in the bathtub, and it was, like, getting bigger than the bathtub, and I don't remember, but, like, it was so scary. I know, so stupid. The goo was so scary as a kid, and it, like, I don't know, scarred me. I don't know if it's, like, my top favorite, but I would say the one that, like, immediately comes to mind that I remember reading when I was a kid for a picture book is this story called The Rough-Faced Girl. And it's kind of a Native American version of Cinderella, and it's just, it's so good. Like, I kind of want it even now.
And for chapter books, I remember when I was a kid, I always read, I think it was called The Bailey School Kids.
And it had, like, always had titles like Frankenstein Doesn't Plant Petunias or something like that. It was, like, I don't know, but I loved them.
All right, 19. Comedy, horror, or chick flick?
Chick flick. Or comedy. Probably not a horror movie because I'm a baby and I'm the only fully grown adult that I know that watches Chucky and then proceeds to check behind her shower curtain before she pees. And doesn't want to watch Jeepers Creepers because then she feels like when she walks out to her car, something's going to calm down from the sky and just swoop you up. And anyway, I don't really do good with that stuff. Okay.
Sorry. I wonder what mine is.
Not a clue.
You know, I don't always talk about all things scary and horror.
We didn't just sit there and watch American Horror Story. It's cool.
I do. At least, but I really do like chick flicks. I mean, probably horror is probably my top category, but we always go see chick flicks together.
No, we do. She sees chick flicks with me.
Because I do love chick flicks.
I will see a horror movie if it's going to be a good one, and it's going to scare me, and I'm going to know that. But then I have to give myself, like, 2 weeks recovery, where I have to be, like, I can't be at home alone. You know what I mean? Like,
yeah.
I have to give myself a little time to unwind.
Favorite movie. What is my favorite movie?
Gone with the Wind.
Okay, guess what I found out today is that 75 years ago, today, Gone with the Wind premiered in Atlanta. My favorite movie of all time. Premiered on my birthday, like, 52 years before I was born. That's pretty perfect. That's pretty awesome.
So, book to movie wish. Like, what book would you like to see turned into a movie?
Ugly series by Scott Westerfeld. At one point, I think that he sold the rights so it could become some sort of, like, TV show or something. I don't know, but I don't think it's ever, like, actually happening. But
it's futuristic and, like, basically, like, when you hit a certain age, you, like, go through the surgery that kind of perfects you. Like, you pick, like, your left or right side, and it just, like, creates symmetry. But it would be, like, a super awesome, like, futuristic film. I would really, really love to see.
I never read The Uglies. Really? I know, like, everybody read them in high school except me.
Everybody read them.
Everybody read them in high school but me. No. And I was the one that read more than anybody.
Specials and extras. I read all of them multiple times. They were great.
But I would say for me, I don't know. I'm going to pick three because I really can't decide which would be a better movie. There's The Unbecoming of Mara Dyer, which would be a really great, like, kind of creepy thriller because it's fantastic. It's so good. Like, 5 stars good.
Then there's The Diviners, which is, like, a historical fiction meets, like, ghosts and horror. And, there's a horror coming. Don't judge me. And then The Devouring would make a really, really good movie.
Oh, I forgot all about that.
Because, like,
The Devouring would make a fantastic movie.
Like, The Fearscape.
And The Fearscape would be a scary movie that I would watch.
Definitely. Yeah, The Fearscape would be so cool, like, actually in a movie.
It'd be awesome.
But nobody ever knows about the series. It's so frustrating.
Okay, go read The Devouring right now. Like, stop what you're doing, quit life, go watch the reading of The Devouring.
But be prepared to have a nightmare as soon as you finish it.
Don't read it at night.
Do you guys have anything matching? Do we have anything matching? I remember we bought, like, bracelets once that were matching, ones.
I was about to say, I think we have, like, a couple bracelet necklaces.
But it was really uncomfortable, so I never wear it.
Yeah, it is. It pokes you every time you move your wrist.
Yeah.
We have matching work jeans.
Yeah, we do.
Matching aprons.
We vlogged about it.
Sharpies.
We did vlog about it.
Does work stuff count? I feel like the jeans should count, but I don't know. I don't think Sharpies count.
Personalities?
I feel like we don't need to have matching things
because we're each other.
Yeah, exactly. We really do.
Finally, last question. Book recommendation for the other.
Recommendations for the other?
Whatever. I can't talk. I'm too tired.
Book recommendation for you. To the girl who's read everything. Yeah, actually, I do, and I don't think that you've read it. It's called, what is it called? The Gift of Fear.
I have never heard of this.
Okay, it's not your normal book. It's not like a fiction novel or anything. It's actually like a, almost like a kind of documentary style. But, I have it. I'll let you borrow it. But basically, it's about trusting your instincts and how, like, fear is a gift. And that when psychologists, like, talk to, like, victims of, like, crime and stuff, they knew it was going to happen. But it's not because they knew, but it's because they saw the signs and just didn't think about it. Like, this one girl was, like, going up to her apartment or something.
Is this, like, a true thing?
Yeah, like, everything in it is real, 100% real. This girl's, like, carrying, like, bags up to her apartment, and she just, like, has this bad feeling. This guy opens the door for her, she's like, thanks, and then she, like, he continues, like, oh, let me help you, and she's like, no, I'm fine, and the bag falls and starts going down the stairs, and she's like, no, I want to get it all myself, I'll get it myself, and the guy helps her, like, you know, he's like, I'm just trying to help you, and he's like, here, just let me set this 7 times, she's like, no, she unlocks her door, and then it turns into, like, a really bad situation, but she knew all along, you know what I mean? Not because he necessarily did or said anything, but because she should have trusted her instincts. It wasn't so much of, like, a friendly stranger. She knew.
If I'm going to recommend a book to you, I would... Okay, I'm going to say one of two things, because they're kind of, like, matching for me, for what you would like.
All right. One is Anna and the French Kiss by Stephanie Perkins, because basically it just fills you with, like, all sorts of warm and fuzzy feelings. It makes you believe in love. It makes you want to, like, just run away to Paris, and it's just completely amazing and beautiful, and it's just, like, it's like a chick flick in a book, but without the Nicholas Sparks endings. Yeah, like, if you're looking for a happy, like, kind of the feeling you get out of movies, read this book. The other one I would recommend is The Selection by Keira Cass, because basically it's, like, almost like The Bachelor. It's like The Bachelor with ball gowns, almost.
Bachelor with ball gowns?
It's like The Bachelor with ball gowns. Basically, they have, like, the society is broken up into castes. Like, you have what, like, if you're caste one, that basically means you're royalty. You're, like, the king, the prince. And then it goes all the way down to caste eight, which is, like, you know, homeless people, people that don't have much of a purpose in this society. And then you get the main characters in caste five, so that's, like, musicians, singers, painters, any kind of artists. So all the castes, and the higher up in the caste you are, like, obviously the better you are. So you want to try and move up in your caste if you can, and marry up. But they also have what they call the selection, which is basically they select like 24 girls or something from all the different castes, and it's basically like kind of like The Bachelor, you know, to marry off to this
prince.
Where
you come from doesn't matter.
And she's already in love with somebody back home who's a caste below her, so it's frowned upon. She ends up getting picked for this selection, you know, and she meets the prince, and there's ball gowns, and they also have to see how well they're going to do as queen, and all of this stuff, and it's just really good. It's so good, and it has, it's really good. You would like it.
All right, that is all of the questions, so I am going to tag a few people. I'm going to tag Emma from Emma's Books.
Emma from Emma's Books.
I'm going to tag Cassie from Miss Sassy Cassie.
Miss Sassy Cassie.
Kelly from Kelly's Bookspill.
Yep, Kelly, you too.
I'm going to tag Ray from Ray of Sunshine Books and Enya from Enya's Corner. Oh!
There you go, Ray and Enya.
Oh, and I'm going to tag Selena from OXX Snap 13 and Sierra from Sierra Reads. I expect you guys to do it together because I know you guys are best friends, so.
And Sierra, you sound awesome.
Yeah. Okay. It's really great. Selena has a best friend named Sierra. My best friend's name is Sierra. It's like, obviously, and it's so funny because I always say that Selena's like my Fwen. We're fake twins. So it's Fwen. That's what we always call each other.
I want a fish named Fwen. My next fish's name is going to be Fwen.
And it's so funny because we're Fwens and we both have best friends named Sierra. It's perfect.
It's fun.
It's really great.
You guys are great friends.
I'm going to stop there because I can't think of anybody else. We love you. I love her.
I love you.
It's my birthday, and she's here.
It is. Actually, it's not her birthday. Her birthday's not till the 18th. Whatever. Don't let this girl lie to you. She was not born today.
Yes, I was. She just thinks she knows better than
me. 3 days later, it'll be her birthday. We'll come back, and we'll do this whole thing.
It doesn't matter how many times I showed her my license.
On the 18th, she was not born the 15th. It's bull hockey.
You forgot my birthday 1 year, and suddenly it's not my birthday
and
anymore.
Sorry. Not true. Her birthday's on the 18th. Don't let her lie to you.
Don't let her lie to you. Okay.
Don't let her lie to you. Okay. Bye.
All right. We will have more videos up soon, hopefully together. Maybe. Yes. Right? Probably. Possibly. Okay. So, yeah. We'll talk to you guys later. Bye.